Step to Christ, the privilege of prayer. Another element of prevailing prayer is faith. He that cometh to God must believe that he is, and that he is a rewarder of them that diligently seek him. Hebrews 11 verse 6. Jesus said to his disciples, "What things soever ye desire, when ye pray, believe that ye receive them, and ye shall have them." Mark 11 verse 24. Do we take him at his word? The assurance is broad and unlimited, and he is faithful who has promised. When we do not receive the very things we ask for at the time we ask, we are still to believe that the Lord hears and that he will answer our prayers. We are so erring and short-sighted that we sometimes ask for things that would not be a blessing to us, and our Heavenly Father in love answers our prayers by giving us that which will be for our highest good, that which we ourselves would desire if with vision divinely enlightened we could see all things as they really are. When our prayers seem not to be answered, we ought to cling to the promise, for the time of answering will surely come, and we shall receive the blessing we need most. But to claim that prayer will always be answered in the very way and for the particular thing that we desire is presumption. God is too wise to err and too good to withhold any good thing from them that walk uprightly. Then do not fear to trust him, even though you do not see the immediate answer to your prayers. Rely upon his sure promise, ask, and it shall be given you. If we take counsel with our doubts and fears, or try to solve everything that we cannot see clearly before we have faith, perplexities will only increase and deepen. But if we come to God, feeling helpless and dependent, as we really are, and in humble, trusting faith make known our wants to him, whose knowledge is infinite, who sees everything in creation, and who governs everything by his will and his word, he can and will attend to our cry and will let light shine into our hearts. Through sincere prayer, we are brought into connection with the mind of the infinite. We may have no remarkable evidence at the time that the face of our Redeemer is bending over us in compassion and love, but this is even so. We may not feel his visible touch, but his hand is upon us in love and pity and tenderness. Step to Christ, page 96.